Here's an article, and the title is The Gospel of Grace versus the Gospel of the Kingdom. That's called a false prophet. The Gospel of the Kingdom versus the Gospel of the Grace. And he's keen to tell you the Gospel of the Kingdom is not for you. Don't believe it. You're not to believe that. You're to believe in the Gospel of the Grace of God. And he then cites Paul in 1 Corinthians 15, where Paul says, I remind you of the gospel which I preached to you, which I received myself. Now, Paul doesn't make it up. I got it from predecessors. And that gospel has to do among things of first importance. Not the whole thing, but the most important things are that Jesus died and was buried and rose. He didn't say that was the totality of the gospel. So they fasten on that one, twist it, and they say, there you go. I quote Billy Graham, who says, Jesus came to do 3 days' work, to die and to be buried and to rise. That is false. I want to go on record and say that is absolutely false, because what happened there was that Jesus was pushed out of the picture. So what has happened in many people's thinking is that Jesus is now made to be under the law of Moses. That would mean he's not the new Moses, he's the old Moses, as well as the new, supposedly. It's just a big muddle. Can we get this clear? Jesus is the mediator of the new covenant, it says in Hebrews. He's the mediator of the new covenant. So all the words of Jesus he gave are new covenant words. That ought to be very clear. I like that idea because it means now, as a Christian, you can say, I'm trying to follow Jesus. He's not at one arm's length removed from me because he's under the law of Moses. That would be false and a big muddle. No, he's the preacher of the new covenant gospel of the kingdom. And of course, when you hear people write, and I hope some out there will be so infuriated that they will go to this site, The Gospel of Grace versus the Gospel of the Kingdom by Nathan Rambeck, Grace to the Humble, and they will challenge this dear man for his own sake, not to win an argument, but to help this poor man not be condemned for nonsense, because he says the gospel of the grace of God is not the same as the gospel of the kingdom. We're going to give you one verse which shows that it is. So Acts 20, verses 24 and 25, Paul is summarizing his own ministry. He's at the end of his ministry. He's looking back and saying, I used to preach to you all the time the gospel of the grace of God. And as I went about preaching the kingdom, you see, it's exactly the same thing. I'm happy to tell you that F.F. Bruce, the late, very distinguished F.F. Bruce, who was kind enough to write private letters to me years back because he liked what we were doing, and he agreed with that totally. That's Acts 20, verses 24, 25. As I went about preaching the gospel of the kingdom, which is the same as the gospel of the grace of God, so that's a falsehood to have one form of the gospel versus the other. It doesn't get any more confusing than that, because you are obliged to believe the gospel of the kingdom, otherwise you can't repent. That's what Jesus said, repent and believe the gospel of the kingdom. And he says, when anybody hears the message of the kingdom, the devil is there to snatch that away. This is Luke 8, 12. Snatch that message of the kingdom away, so they cannot believe and get saved. What? Yes, it's not repent and give up beating your wife. That would be excellent. It's not repent and be a good chap, what I learned in the Church of England. It's repent and stop not believing in the kingdom of God, which is your destiny and the destiny of the second Adam, who is Jesus. Now we're getting somewhere near the truth. And if we're wrong, of course, you people out there in the audience will kindly tap us on the shoulder and say, no, you're wrong. The gospel of grace is not the same as the gospel of the kingdom. Well, it actually is, because Acts 20, verses 24, 25. So guess what happens in this article? He cites verse 24, and then he doesn't cite verse 25. What? That is very, very distressing to me.